So we have already derived the relation between the line values and phase values in case of the star connected balanced load. Okay, in that we have seen that the line voltage is equal to root 3 times of phase voltage and line current is equal to the phase current in case of the star connected balanced load. So next is that the phasor diagrams. In the phasor diagrams, which shows the relations between the phase voltage and the phase current, and the current which drawn by the load, that will be depends upon which type of the nature of the load is there. So here, if the nature of, that means the nature of current depends upon the per phase impedance. The per phase impedance, whether it is inductive, capacitive or the resistive, depends upon that the current will be drawn by the load, that means the, by the impedance. So here we can see that if impedance is inductive, that means the total impedance per phase, which will be equals to R per phase plus J times XLPH, that is the inductive reactance per phase. In that case, the phase current is lagging behind the phase voltage by angle phi, and the magnitude of that angle phi will be calculated as phi is equal to tan inverse XL upon R per phase. That means here, if the impedance ZPH, that is the phase impedance, is inductive, in that case current, that is I phase, is lagging behind the V phase by angle phi, which will be given by the equation tan inverse XL upon R per phase. When the impedance is capacitive, that means the nature of the impedance is capacitive, in that case the total impedance Z will be given as RPH minus ZXCPH, that means it is the R per phase and XC per phase, and phase current is leading with the phase voltage in case of the capacitive load, and the angle phi, which is lead current by angle phi, will be given as tan inverse minus XC upon R per phase. That means if the nature of the load is capacitive, in that case phase current is leading with the phase voltage by angle phi. If the impedance, that is Z per phase, is resistive, in that case the phase current is in phase with the phase voltage. That means there is no leading and the lagging of the current I in, for the voltage per phase. That means here, whatever phi is the angle, phi is the angle that will be depends upon per phase values of the voltage and the current. So whatever value of the phi, that is always calculated in the voltage per phase and the current per phase. Then we'll see the phasor diagram for inductive load. So this is the from this we can calculate that how is the nature of the current per phase when the impedance is whether inductive, capacitive or resistive. From that we can draw the phasor diagram, complete phasor diagram for inductive load. So we have seen that VRY, that is the line voltage, which can be given as VRN plus minus VIN. VYB is the line voltage between Y and V, is nothing but equals to VYN plus minus VBN, and line voltage VBR is equal to VBN plus minus VRN. From this we can draw the phasor diagram for inductive loads. So in inductive load, that means the phase current IPH is lagging behind the voltage VPH. So the complete phasor diagram for this we can draw by taking the reference voltage, that is VRN. So keep, you just concentrate how to draw this phasor diagram. So this is nothing but your VRN. This phasor is rotated in the anti-clockwise direction. So 180 degree phase shift between this three phasors, that is it is 120 degree behind this VRN, that is VYN, and 120 degree behind this VYN, this is VBN. So all these are nothing but the phase voltages. This is nothing but phase voltage, this is nothing but VPH, and this is nothing but VPH. From this we need to calculate value of the line voltages, because we are drawing here the complete phasor diagram for the inductive load. So VRY, that will be given as the VRN plus minus VYN. So minus VYN is nothing but by reversing the phasor VYN, will get the minus VYN. So summation of this minus VYN and VRN is nothing but we'll get the magnitude of the line voltage VRY. So this value is nothing but minus Vyn, and summation of this Vyn and Vrn is nothing but line voltage Vry. So Vry is nothing but, we can see this is the Vrn, this is the minus Vin. So summation of the phase voltage Vrn and minus Vyn is nothing but Vry. Similarly, we can draw the value of line voltage Vyb. Vyb is nothing but Vyn plus minus Vbn. So this is nothing but minus Vbn So this value is nothing but minus Vbn. So Vyn plus minus Vbn is nothing but, this is the value of Vyb. Similarly, we can get the value of line voltage Vbr, which is equals to Vbn plus minus Vrn. So this is nothing but minus Vrn. So summation of this, we'll get the value of line voltage Vbr. So all these are nothing but the line voltage. This is line voltage, this is nothing but the line voltage, and this Vry is nothing but line voltage. So here we want to show the relations between the phase current and the phase voltage for the inductive load, and that we know that the value of the phase angle phi, that is always given in between the phase values of voltage and the current. So this, we want to show the value of the phi, which is lagging behind the phi, and the current I per phase, that will be lagging behind this voltage by angle phi. So this is nothing but I per phase, that will be lagging behind the voltage VPH by angle phi. So this is nothing but, we can say this is the value of IR, that will be lagging behind the voltage VRN. Similarly, here you can draw the value of this current IY, and here the current IB. So all these will be lagging behind the voltages, that is phase voltages, by an angle phi. So in this way, we can draw the complete phasor diagram for the inductive load. Similarly, we can draw the complete phasor diagram for the capacitive load. Only the change here between this inductive load and the capacitive load phasor diagram is that this phase current is leading with the phase voltage by an angle phi. That means if I want to show here the phasor diagram for the capacitive load, in that case, instead of this current, that is the phase current, is lagging behind the phase voltage, that will be leading with the phase voltage. So this is nothing but, you can say, this IR, that will be leading with the phase voltage by angle phi. This such type of diagram is nothing but the phasor diagram for the capacitive load. Similarly, you can draw the complete phasor diagram for the resistive load. In that case, the phase angle between voltage and the current is zero. That means here, this current, you can show in phase with the phase voltage Vrn. So this is nothing but the current Ir in case of the resistive load. So that way, we can draw the complete phasor diagram for the inductive load, capacitive load, and the resistive load. Only the thing that you have to remember while drawing the phasor diagrams for the inductive, capacitive, and resistive load, and that is what, key phase current is always lagging behind the phase voltage in inductive load, phase current is always leading with the phase voltage in capacitive load, and the phase current is in phase with the phase voltage in case of resistive load.